Two more victims of this ice plague. Carl felt a chill down his spine. What if he was next? Felt the strong pull of a vision overcome him. It looked like a simple hunting accident. There was Hamilton. Carl recognized him. A major hunting accident. The doctor examined the young woman. But death couldn't be overturned. She was dead. It was not the type of body you buried in a big ceremony in the village graveyard. It had to be hidden. No one could know about this. The best way to do that was to have a simple-minded man bury the poor girl, Lamotte, the mechanic. The doctor denied the unfair death of the young woman, but Hamilton had him in his grips. Hamilton knew all of the poet's secrets and wouldn't hesitate to reveal them. "I know all about your crimes, you little communist. You know mine. What a sordid affair." Understood the ins and outs of the affair. A woman had been killed in an unfair accident, and a young warrior had damned himself to avenge her. But Hamilton Hamilton, the one responsible, had already been killed, and so the beast could not quench its thirst for vengeance. And now, recklessly, Carl had pulled a bolt from the beast's heart. A beast who was but a young Cree man lost without his fiancée, and who had, out of hatred, become Wendigo. Narrow passage sheltered him, but for how long? When you disappeared, so did Purity. I would defend Purity against the winds, the tides, against ice and blizzard. Could it be that all this was but a story of justice and vengeance? The soulful doctor, avenging his fiancée's unjust death by avenging this young woman as though she was his lover. Are these passionate feelings not precisely the kind of feelings that could cause a storm, petrify people deep inside, create monsters?
Un survivant! On a trouvé un survivant!